Well, I was on supplements from the age of 14. You have to be.
Right.
Because of the hours you're training and the amount of weights you're lifting.
I want to talk about your diet. Like, how did it go?
My diet?
Your diet when you were training professionally.
When I was training, swimmers are very lucky because we burn so many calories through a day that we are allowed to eat pretty much everything when we are training hard.
Plus, you were 16, 17, so the metabolism is so
huge.
Super.
It still is. I still have a huge, and we are Parsi. So, Parsis eat pretty much everything. We love our food, and I am a foodie.
Right.
So, but it wasn't ever really a challenge because to stay off junk and to stay off sugar when I needed to didn't feel like a challenge because it just felt like part of the other hard work that I'm doing to reach my goals.
But did you really have to leave junk or something?
I did. I would. You can't really eat desserts and sugar and junk every day because no matter how hard you're training, you're going to put on excess body fat, which only hurts you in the pool. So in terms of diet, generically you have to have lots of carbs pre-practice and lots of protein after practice, and then you've got your whey protein shakes,
even when you were 16, you were having your
supplements. I was on supplements from the age of 14. You have to be.
Right.
Because of the hours you're training and the amount of weights you're lifting, you can't do it only on a just a pure diet. Especially back in 99 and 2000 when we didn't have the science and the brains that we have today, where today people are talking about going vegan.
Yeah, plant-based.
And plant-based and just getting off all sort of supplement completely. We didn't have that knowledge at that point.
Sure. Yeah.
Having said that, I was very, I mean, my dad and my mom very careful as to what they gave me. Because on one hand, you don't want to take anything that's damaging to a young kid.
Right.
On the other, we have to be very careful also because you've got certain standards that you have to meet.
Right.
And you cannot be cheating and, you know, having anything that is illegal either.
Right.
So I was obsessively careful about what I had and didn't have in terms of supplements. But yes, there was a protein supplement that I had to have post-workout. I would make sure I got enough carbs in before in terms of rice and potato and fruit.
And that time, all these supplements were mostly imported. And if you buy it from India, there were a lot of cases of adulteration, right? So you have to be really careful with
your diet. Only in India, even abroad, you would have, because a lot of the best manufacturers, the top companies have one plant that manufactures for bodybuilders, where steroids abuse and steroids are allowed.
Yeah, yeah.
And then another plant with the same company that manufactures for all other athletes.
Right.
Sometimes there could be cross contamination.
Sure, sure.
So we had to be very careful. Only reputed companies were ones that we used. Once I used a supplement, that was what I stuck through my own career.
Okay.
Just to be safe.
Right. Yeah. So did you have a dedicated dietitian or nutritionist with you?
My dad.
Your dad. So doesn't the board take care of the best player on the board, the swimming board? No,
because we came together as a national team only a month out of a big tournament.
Okay.
Right. So the swimming fraternity is such that while most of the top swimmers come out of Bangalore, you've got two or three good centers, at least in my time and even now.
Right.
Training all of us in Bangalore, some from Delhi, some from up, down south. But primarily, we are all training together in one or two of these centers in Bangalore.
Right.
And we go to our national championships, and the best swimmers at that national championships get selected as part of the national team to race abroad.
Right.
Then we all come together in a national camp,
right,
which is either in Delhi or in Bangalore, again at the Sports Authority of India Center. There are in-house doctors and nutritionists, but rarely do you want to change around a pattern or a program that you're working with
that works for
you the whole year that's been working,
right?
Just especially 1 month out of a major tournament,
right?
Because you can't even begin to trust that person till you work with him for a longer period of time. And I'm not trusting a doctor I've met plan to meet only for 20 days leading up to my meet. So we've got our own systems and setup. Today when I play golf, I have nutritionists working with me.
Right.
We are talking about, not that even 6 or 7 years ago, Indian nutritionists were starting to become popular with athletes.
Sports nutritionists. They weren't. Yeah.
It wasn't a big field
before
that.
Right.
So like I said, that was done through my dad, and my dad also is in the industry.
Okay.
So it's not like he was an absolute layman.
Right.
He makes food and medicines for racehorses.
The way you behave and talk, you look like you have a military background. I don't think that's the case.
I don't have a military background.
Stereotypical, but you have that.
No, so he and we always make sure we were thorough with our what we felt we needed to do.
Right.
And again, it's trial and error.
Right.
It's figuring out what works best for you, because you can be working with the best nutritionist in the country. But after a point, you have to figure out, and I tell this to swimmers who I train today,
right,
that I may be a great coach or not, but that final bit is on you.
Right.
And how you put together your race, or how you put together your food. Or
right.
So we are coaches, and experts are there for advice and to steer an athlete in the right direction.
Right.
But then he has to go down that road himself at the end of the day.